Hey y'all, so I'm about to go hiking. I'm about to go to Estrella Park. I think that's what it's called. Let me double check. I think it's called Estrella Mountain Park. So we don't really know what trail we're going to do. I think we kind of narrowed it down, but it's called, let's see. Yeah, Estrella Mountain Regional Park. So hopefully it's 3 o'clock, so it's pretty hot, but it is going to get cooler, so hopefully it's not like too hot. Y'all know I like hiking, so I really just want to, you know, get in some nature and really take in the scenes. Like Arizona mountains and cactus and desert is really beautiful, so I'm really excited to get in that vibe real quick. Supposed to go out tonight, so I just hope I'm not too tired. I get so winded easily. But anyway, I just wanted to check in with y'all and let y'all know that I'm about to go hiking, and I'll show you guys, of course, what it looks like. I'm not gonna film too much of the hiking because it's just literally gonna be like mountains and cactuses, but I will get, you know, a couple clips here and there. So yeah, that's what I'm up to for today, pretty much. So yeah, we're about to go up this mountain to the cactus up there. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it's up top. Oh, there's actually a cross up there too. Anyway, we're about to continue to hike. It's around 5 or 6. Y'all, we are on our trail. Hey girl. Yes. Stay shaded and hydrated, okay?
And in shape.
It's 6 a.m. Last night I was gonna go out, I went hiking and was gonna go out for a little bit. I went to get my like my bag together for the night, like grab my ID, my car, lip gloss, hand sanitizer, lotion. I'm looking for my ID and I can't find my ID. Yeah, y'all, I lost my ID. It's aggravating because I'm gonna need that to get, that's what they needed for me to board the plane. So I'm trying to figure out what I need to do. I looked through my bags yesterday, I looked in the car. I even went back, we went hiking, and I remember putting my, right, I put my bag in the trunk, and then we went to go get gas, and I remember, like, I was shuffling through, like, my cards and my cash, because I was trying to figure out if I wanted to do card or cash for gas, so I did cash, but I think when I was getting my cash, it fell out, and that gas station that we went to in Goodyear is, like, popping. So yeah, I am worried. I remember IDs out here. If you lose an ID, you know, like people steal IDs and they sell it. So anyway, I'm about to call the airport and see what they say. Surprisingly, you didn't need a COVID test for the airport anymore. I guess when they dropped the mask restriction at the airport and the COVID test dropped too. So yeah, if you guys are flying somewhere, you don't have to get the COVID test domestically in the United States. But yeah, so I went back to the gas station. The guy that checked me out was not there, but I asked another gentleman and I asked a woman. I looked all on the ground and I did not see it. By that time, it had already been like 2 hours or an hour. I'm so mad because now I have to pay to replace. Well, I'm gonna call that gas station again to see if they have it. This is probably not a...
No, I don't have any IDs in here.
Okay, I appreciate you looking. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Bye. Okay, so I just got off the phone with the airport, and the operator just answered my question. I didn't have to talk to TSA, but she said just a lot, 20 to 30 minutes extra time. If you lose your ID, they'll just they're gonna ask you some questions, like to verify yourself, personal questions to verify your identity. So, and I do have other cards in my wallet that like have my name and stuff. I'm about to get up right now and just like go through everything, check everything. I was keeping my ID in my side pocket on my carry-on bag or my personal item, but it's not in there anymore. I remember taking it out and putting it in my wallet. So it's probably falling out somewhere. So anyway, I'm still good though. I can still fly back home. I ain't gotta worry about it. So I'm happy about that. Anyway, y'all, I'm about to go and enjoy my day. I'll talk to y'all later.
Hey y'all, what's up? It is,
what day is it? It's Saturday. So I found a, when I was in Denver, when I was looking in Phoenix for things to do, I searched like the city's Instagram. So there's a page called Downtown Phoenix, and I saw that there's a district called Historic Grand Avenue. So I am here right now, and it looks pretty small, but it does look interesting. So I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like and what I find. I have minimal makeup on today. I just really could not be bothered today. I just get so tired from being out all day and then having to be in the bathroom taking it off. It's such a process because I like to get every ounce and piece of makeup off. So it just takes me a while. So I prefer to just do the bare minimum at night and head to sleep. So I just didn't want to do any this weekend or tomorrow. I won't be doing it. I just have a little bit of gloss, brows, and like mascara on. So yeah, I'm going to check it out. So let's go. All right, so this is kind of like what it looks like so far, how long it is.
A really cool just walk-in casual gallery. So right now the host is Joan Thompson, so this is her artwork that I'm showing. I really like this piece. This is really, really cool. It looks like a sewing pin. So I met the curator, the current curator that's being hosted there, and another one of their collective members. They were so sweet, Deborah and Joan, like, oh my gosh. So they do a lot of things, and there's a art community here. So, and it was free to just walk in that gallery. So if you guys are just in town looking for something to do, I highly recommend coming to this area, especially if you're bored and you just want something to do. All the trees on this street are decorated. They almost look like pinatas. So I'm in this really cool salon. That has plants. Oh, they use InnerSense. These beautiful paintings. Like, I'm somebody who's in the industry because I'm an esthetician. So, you know, I've worked in salons, different salon spaces where it's more commercial or it's more very, very, you know, in areas where it's like even more non-traditional and like mom and pop or just independently owned. So I've worked in a numerous salon spaces. So it's really refreshing when you see like creative, independently owned, any kind of space, honestly. So the owner of that place is, it's two people, so it's an artist and a salon. So I was gonna say salon therapist, but a salon artist as well, stylist. And on First Fridays, they said that they have more things going on. So let's continue on our journey. So I'm gonna try it out. All right, y'all, I decided to come back here to see what they have. I think this is what the guy was recommending, that they have $5 burritos. Everything is pre-made, kind of like Starbucks, so they don't do any customization, which is a big bummer because I wanted a burrito with like the onions and sauteed potatoes and tomatoes, but they don't do any like customization. So when I walked down the street, this guy was like, oh, there's this place with $5 burritos. So then that got me the food for it. But I don't want just beans and tortilla, like I want some added flavor to it. But they don't do any customization. So we'll see how this is. I got the vegan frijol without the vegan cheese. Number one, I don't do cheese, and then vegan cheese, I know it can be weird. So let's try it. That's still pretty good. So, I have these two sauces. I'm gonna try them with the sauce.
I'm gonna try it with this green sauce.
The green sauce is actually really, really good. It smells like... Ooh, that's spicy and smoky. But it's really good though. Okay, one thing about being out here in Arizona, you're gonna tan different. Like, I tan differently here spending the summers here and being in the sun versus being in North Carolina and tanning. Tanning in North Carolina, I get more like an orange tone versus here. I feel like my tone becomes more like a red golden. It's beautiful. I love an Arizona tan. It's the same sun, but I swear, y'all, it's different. You just tan differently, I swear. I feel like different places, just you get like different rays from the sun. So, yep. I definitely have gotten more of a tan and I'm loving it. Everybody's gonna be so jealous when I get back home. Like, where you been at? You look like you've been in Bali somewhere. Whew. Anyway, y'all, let me get to my next destination, which is Central Ave. Apparently is like a little hipster cool vibe. 7th Street and 7th Avenue also. I just met somebody in a shop and she recommended a few of those places, so I'm gonna try them out, see what's going on. I have to meet my mom at the movies at 5:45, so we'll be doing that. She wants to go see Downton Abbey, y'all. My mom really likes British film and stuff like that, so we're gonna go do that because everything else that we've done, I pretty much wanted to do, so I can't have everything my way, unfortunately. So, yeah. I obviously can't vlog in the movie theater, and I won't be. So, yeah, I'll see y'all after. Hey, y'all, so it is now Sunday. I'm really upset because I didn't really get to do anything today, but I am back at the airport in Phoenix, so I will be headed back to Charlotte. I have like an hour layover in Denver, but my flight got delayed by 30 minutes, so it's not a big deal. There was like no TSA line like at all, so I didn't have any long wait or anything, so I have more time to show y'all some of the Phoenix airport in case you're interested in it. I'll show you guys what it looks like. Look at not the Delta Sky Club looking hella official. Like, do people say hella anymore? But yeah, this looks like, it looks like there's a spa in there. Like they do pedicure chairs or something. Okay. That's probably over my budget. But anyway, I'm gonna show you guys some of the restaurants. I'm now in the Gate F area. It's really nice. I like how some of the restaurants look. It's not as many restaurants. I don't think it's as big as the Charlotte airport either, but I'll show you guys what the airport looks like. Go down to the E-gates and see if they have anything down there and show y'all what that looks like. One thing I can say about this airport is that it's very simple and easy to navigate, drive to, walk through. Like, it's very, very simple. So yeah, I don't know what the difference between E and F, if there's really a difference. These might be nicer. This end for these, there's a little bit more down on F. So, yeah, I'm about to turn around. Y'all, so my hair is dry as hell. Like, I washed my hair. As I was saying, I was washing my hair. I washed my hair one time this trip and I thought everything was good, and I used Afro Love and everything, but with this Arizona heat, it just obviously like dried my hair out because my hair is super dry. Like, if it can't stand Afro Love, the weather out here, like, that's my best hair products that resist any kind of weather. So yeah, all the moisture is completely gone from my hair. I'm actually looking forward to going back to North Carolina so that my hair, you know, can last a couple days, because this is like, this is, my hair never gets this dry in this state, unless it's like day 8. So that's 8 total days, almost like 2 weeks in the natural hair community, right? 8 days. So this is just, I'm just like, wow. I would definitely have to figure out, if I ever were to move here or come back, I would have to figure out a hair regimen. And that's if I keep my hair this length. I really do want to get it shaped. But yeah. Lost my ID, yeah. So they pretty much pulled me aside and asked me a bunch of questions, and had to, like, they checked my my debit card and my health insurance card, and then like thoroughly checked my stuff. But anyway, I'm in Denver right now. It is 11:15 p.m. and this airport is crazy. My dad did say that there was a bunch of layovers. That or not layovers, but a bunch of cancellations. I don't know if it's because a Memorial Day weekend or what, but this airport is crazy packed right now. I don't think I've ever seen an airport this busy outside of maybe Miami, and well, it's been a busy Atlanta. Atlanta's been a busy airport too. Anyway, I'm about to board my next flight. I think it doesn't leave till like 12. So I'm going to be waiting on that soon. All right, so the gate has changed again with Frontier. It was 8:52 on my boarding pass, but I had to ask. Luckily, I saw a Frontier flight attendant, so she helped me read the sign. I'm just tired. I almost fell asleep, but I was talking on the plane, which was really cool. I met some cool people, but I'm tired. So anyway, my gate has changed to 8:36. Frontier, I really like flying. They have really good prices. The seats are comfortable, and the staff is always nice. I've always had a really good experience with the staff. But y'all, they be changing the gates and don't announcing it. You really have to look at the signs and ask, seriously, or you will. I was literally at 8:52, but that was American. So I am halfway awake. So I'm glad that I'm like paying attention. I mean, obviously I would pay attention, but I'm just saying, you definitely do with flights. But yeah, I've never seen it this busy, and it's really late. Like, it's 11:22. And it's like so many people in here. Where is everybody going? It is Memorial Day weekend, so. Alright, anyway, my arm's hurting and I'm tired and I need to charge my phone. So I will talk to y'all later. This will probably be the last clip. I don't think I'm gonna really vlog anymore, but thank you guys for tuning in and watching my vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. learn some new places to go in Arizona or Denver as well. So yeah, until my next vlog, see ya.